We can now add in some subheadings. Our first step is to take our text tool, draw out a text frame, and put in the name of the spice. To edit the font style and size, push Ctrl T. You can also access this panel by going Window, and then look for the Type and Tables, and choose Character. Once here, I can select the font, and I can start typing in the font that I want. And I can also edit the size, and I know that 24 points is a great choice. We're going to center our text by going up to the Paragraph Style option. I'm going to scroll down to the bottom, and with my text box selected, go Control Plus. This is going to add a new paragraph style that has the same character formats that we've just applied. We can double-click on the paragraph style and give it a name. If you change your mind on the font, you can edit it in the basic character formats area. More importantly, we can also change the alignment to centered. Once we're happy, we can go OK. This makes life a lot easier because for my next text heading, I can simply draw my text box, type in the heading, push the H2 paragraph in my paragraph styles area. We can expand and collapse our paragraph styles area by using the two arrows at the top. And even if it's collapsed, we can go Control Enter to use our quick apply, and we can then choose the style that we want. You might have noticed that it's a little bit hard to read some of the text because the images are quite strong. To fix that, you'll want to go into the color area and choose a white fill and say OK. This has fixed our readability issue, but now we've lost some of the image. I'd like to add some padding to this container as well. To do that, I go Control B. To add padding, simply increase the inset spacing. If you only wanted to add padding on one side, you'd need to unlink the chain before you change the amount of spacing. Our next step is to make this box semi-transparent. To do this, please go Object, Effects, and Transparency. This time round, make sure that you choose the fill rather than the entire object, and we can adjust the transparency. With the preview button ticked, change the transparency, maybe make it 75%, and tap Tab, and this will let you see if the transparency is too much or too little. Then click OK. This took several steps, and ideally, we want to be able to apply this style to our other boxes. The quickest way to do this is to go back into the window area, and this time round, you're wanting to choose styles, and we're wanting object styles. Just like before, we can go Control Plus, and we can create an object style. Double click to edit it, call it something like H2 box, and say OK. Now we can go back to our other headings, and we can click on them, press Control Enter for our quick apply, and this time we're wanting to choose H2 box. You can type H2 in the box to filter the styles, and then push Enter to apply. If you notice any typos, now's a great time to fix them. If the height of your boxes is not consistent, please select the box and go Ctrl-Alt-C. This will shrink the box to the size of the text, and you can then draw the box back out so that it's the width that you need it to be. I've gone ahead and created a label for salt. If I go Ctrl-Enter and I apply the box, you'll notice that it applies my semi-transparent background and padding, but it doesn't put in the correct font. The fix is easy. I simply need to apply the paragraph style, and of course, I can then move it up to where it needs to be. As long as you have a style set up, it's perfectly okay to use copy and paste to quickly generate the remaining headings. With our style set up, if we want to change the font, we can go into our paragraph style, and we can go back to those basic character formats and change the font style and even the font size. When we apply it, you'll notice that everything that has the style applied to it automatically changes.